Here we will be discussing about HTML language. It is a formal language used to communicate with a computer and creating web applications. HTML is an acronym which stands for Hypertext Markup Language. It's used for creating web pages. Hypertext simply means text within text. A text has a link within it is a hypertext. Whenever you clicking on a link which brings to a new web page, hypertext is a way to link two or more web pages with each other. Markup language is a computer language that is used to apply layout and formatting conventions to a text document. Markup language makes text more interactive and dynamic. It can turn text into images, tables, links, etc. Web page is a document which is commonly written in HTML and translated by a web browser. A web page can be identified by entering in the URL. A uniform resource locator is the address of a specific web page. A web page can be of static or dynamic type. To write HTML code, you required a text editor. The text editors are the programs which allow editing in a written text, hence to create a web page you need to write your code in text editor. You have a lot of HTML editor options, which you can download for free from the websites. But it's important to pick a reliable and time-saving professional text editor. After learning the basics, you can use professional text editors, but for a beginner, the best text editor is Notepad in Windows. Notepad is available in all versions of Windows. Here you can easily access it. Let's see. Open Notepad from Windows. In the search bar, simply type Notepad. The Notepad icon appear, then click it. Notepad will open. Now we will write the HTML code here. Please keep patience. After written the HTML code will open the Notepad page in browser. We will discuss about coding, tag and output, in Notepad and browser page, so that everyone can understand it. HTML tags writings that we have already started, such as HTML tag to informs the browser that it is an HTML document. Head tag is information about the document. Title tag to add title. Body tag is content of the page. H1 to H3 tag to display largest to smallest font. P tag for blank line. B tag for text bold. Font tag used for size and color, etc. U tag for text underline. BR tag for line break. I tag for make the content italic. HR tag as a horizontal rule. Sub tag as subscript text. SUP tag as superscript text. Align tag used for horizontal alignment. Marquee tag to create a scrolling effect. LI tag define list item. And IMG tag used to set an image. After writing the code, we will click in the file menu and select save as option from drop-down list. The save as window appear. Here we will write the file name with .html. The extension part .html or htm is mandatory. If you have not changed the file extension part, the file will not open in the browser like Google Chrome and Mozilla Firefox, etc. Now we will open the existing file from browser which is saved in Google Chrome format. To open HTML file in browser, right click in the HTML file and from open with option, select the required browser. The file will appear in your screen as web page. If you want to display the HTML file in text mode or in the Notepad, right click in the HTML file and from open with option, select the Notepad. The file will appear in your screen as text based. Here you can edit or modify your file. After editing, you should be save the file in Notepad. Then you go to web page or browser and click refresh or reload. The modified structure of what you have edited will appear in the screen. Let us now discuss HTML tags and coding in detail. Exclamation mark and doc type with angle brackets. All HTML documents must start with an exclamation mark and doc type HTML under angle brackets declaration. This declaration is not an HTML tag. The doc type declaration defines the document type, or it instructs the browser about what version of HTML the document is written. It is a HTML5 declaration. Opening HTML tag with angle brackets and closing HTML tag with forward slash as well as angle brackets. The HTML syntax uses angle brackets to hold the name of an HTML element. Elements usually have an opening tag and a closing tag. The difference between the two is that the closing tag has a forward slash to let browsers know where to start and end different elements. HTML is often written with opening closing tag. This tag informs the browser that it is an HTML document. Text between HTML tag describes the web document. So, thus we proceed to understand with opening and closing angle brackets. Head tag should be the first element inside the HTML element, which contains the information about the document. It must be closed before the body tag opens. Title tag is used to add title of that HTML page which appears at the top of the browser window. It must be placed inside the head tag and should close. Body tag, text between body tag describes the body content of the page that is visible to the user. This tag the main content of the HTML document. The BG color attribute is used to set the background color or font color of an HTML element. H1 to H6 tag, this tag can define the web page's heading. The H1 headings are displayed in the largest font, whereas the H6 headings are displayed in the smallest font. P tag defines a paragraph. Browsers automatically add a single blank line before and after each P element. B tag, with the help of this tag, we can make the text bold without any additional significance. Font tag used to define the font size, color, and face for text content within the document. The font tag includes several attributes, with the most common are size, to specify the size of the font, color, to define the color of the text, face, to set the font style in the font family. U tag represents text that is declare the content displayed with an underline. BR tag, with the help of this tag, we can align break on the web page. I tag, with the help of this tag, you can make any content italic. It highlights an important term, phrase, or technical term. HR tag, element is displayed as a horizontal rule that is used to separate content in an HTML page, and the no shade attribute specifies that the HR element should appear as a solid line. Subscript text appears half a character below the normal line and is sometimes rendered in a smaller font. Subscript text can be used for chemical formulas. Superscript text appears half a character above the normal line and rendered in a smaller font. Superscript text can be used for footnotes and math formula. Align attribute is used to specify the alignment of the text content of the element. This attribute is used in all elements. It for horizontal alignment, used align with values like left, center, or right, within appropriate tags. Marquee tag is used to create a scrolling effect for text or images. You can control the text to reaches the edges of its content areas using its attributes. This tag can make the content move left, right, up, or down. LI tag defines a list item. The LI tag is used OL as ordered lists and UL as unordered lists. In UL tag, the list items will usually be displayed with bullet points. In OL, the list items will usually be displayed with numbers or letters. IMG tag is used to set an image in an HTML page. The IMG tag creates a space for holding the referenced image. The IMG tag required attribute is SRC. It specifies the path to the image. Also, you can specify the width and height of an image. That's it. Would you like to know more interesting information? In this channel you will find engaging facts. If you like this video, visit to this channel and type the comment in comment section. If you found that this tutorial helpful, do like and subscribe. Watch other tutorials by IQIT Krishnendu channel. Thanks for watching.